Why is my shit not working? What up, y'all?
Uh-huh. Ain't y'all really feel me?
Well, that sounds like shit. Hold on a second. All right, let's, there we go. Fucking in the start in the middle of a sentence.
Say what?
How y'all doing out there?
Baby girl.
It's Monday. It's Monday. We got a fucking wacky show for you today. If we're doing news from the fringe, talking to a former cult member who's also a rapper and a comedian. So we're gonna I'm gonna talk about her cult for a while, and it might turn into a hate or love it with comedy, which is very rare, but I want to start doing that. I want to start doing hate it or love it for comedians. I think that could be radio gold.
Painful.
Radio gold. Speaking of radio gold, I'm waiting to hear back from this dude that he hit me up on Instagram, which I'm still shadow banned from, and I got flagged again. I had this fucking sweet meme. It had the Nazi flag, and it said, kill yourself after you lose. And then it had the Japanese flag, and it said, kill yourself before you lose. Then I had the fucking ISIS flag, and it says, kill yourself before you win. And then I had a PTSD, and it said, kill yourself after you win. Well, the vets fucking loved that shit. The vets fucking loved it. They shared it. They was like, Jude, that shit is funny as hell. Bro, do you know the shit that they've seen? Do you understand the shit that vets have seen? Do you think a fucking meme is gonna fuck them up? And no. Especially they know me. Who's one of the biggest advocates that brings on cats for fucking veteran suicide, PTSD, all that shit? Judy. I hate that I have to keep saying this fucking shit. Yeah, fucking flagged. I hate you stupid fucks. I wish you dumb motherfuckers didn't follow me. If you stupid, like if you don't get my jokes, just unfollow me, man. I guarantee you it was not a fucking, I guarantee you it was not military that fucking told on me on that one. And I can't even go private now. They won't even let me go private now.
What happens when you try?
When I go private and then fucking okay people, they're like, you are manipulating the system. I'm like, what? So I can't even go private. I gotta go public. The only reason why I'm on Instagram is to sell fucking wine. I think we're down to 500 bottles, y'all. Or it was 500 last week. And we've been selling. It's less than 500 now. And if you get for every bottle you get, you enter yourself to get the ill fucking hummingbird bomber. Sage Vaughn did the art. And it's one of a kind. Limited edition made it for me. It's beautiful. If limited edition is listening, please DM me, because I don't know how to, I don't know what your tag is. Just follow my backup, Angelini.Jude, or fucking sign up for my goddamn email. Go to onemorejude.com. Just so I can get in touch with you, because I don't know how long I'm going to be there. They keep fucking with me.
Well, I don't want to jinx it, but do you really think that's happening? That you'll get just booted?
Dude, if you're not following me and you type in my name, I got 420,000 followers. One more should... I'm the biggest one more, so that should come up. Boom. Immediately, you got to type in my whole fucking name before anything even comes in.
Don't we know somebody who could sort of take the heat off?
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, I've got to look into that.
Hey, Alex,
crazy.
Can you hit up Alex, can you hit up somebody that deals in Sirius that can fucking get people off my fucking back over there, Instagram?
Yeah, we got Sirius XM, we got Pandora, we got a whole empire going here. You think we can make a phone call?
Yeah.
All right, fine.
The stop fucking with me phone call.
Yeah.
The leave me the fuck alone phone call. Fucking drives me crazy, dude. Whatever, man. But I'm just trying to put out thought-provoking, funny yet thought-provoking things out for the masses. But people hate fucking thinking. So their first knee-jerk reaction is to get fucking mad, and then they go tell. Thank you to all the military cats, too. They fuck with me tough. They listen overseas and shit. I appreciate y'all. Even though I don't agree with our foreign policy, I know y'all don't make that shit up. So fucking cheers to y'all cats. Thank you. Appreciate you. Here, we got Adam in Long Island that wants us to use Snapchat, fuck IG. I don't even want to talk to him. Snapchat fucking is awful. It's good for porn chicks. Where's my military at? If you was a military person and you told on me, call me up right now. I want to fucking know.
You told on me.
I want to fucking know. If you didn't tell on me, you can call up too. Adam in Long Island, what up, man?
Yo, Jude, what up, man?
Go ahead, Doug.
Just want to say happy Monday, man, and spread some good vibes to everyone listening out there, bro. That's busting ass.
All right. I heard you got a promotion at work. What do you do?
I do executive protection service, so pretty much they gave me a little bump. I got my own like personal truck for the whole week, and they hooked me up with a hotel room Wednesday through Friday in Times Square.
Hey. Well, how did you
I mean, first they started me off, you know, just doing basic detail stuff at, you know, hotels, buildings, stuff like that. But then I guess they liked what they saw, and they hooked me up with a little extra bump.
Nice.
Fuck, but man. You know, just want to let people know, you bust your ass, do your fucking thing, man. Shit, nothing can stop you, man.
Grind hard, take chances. You gotta take chances. Yeah, chances make champions.
You hear that, John? You hear that, John? You better use my words in that ring, bro.
Chances make champions. Grind hard.
You better knock Chris's bitch ass out, man.
Good luck with that.
How's your chin anyway, Chris? Is it decent or not?
My chin?
Yeah.
My chin's weak.
All right, there you go, John. Just aim for the chin. It's going to be chin versus chin. John's going to aim for Chris's chin, and Chris is going to... I don't know, man. You might break your whole fucking arm on John's chin.
If he can get that close.
It might be like going into a cave and punching a stalactite. That's what is... Yo, you could camouflage yourself in a cave. Nobody would even find you.
Right, just walk by.
They'd be like, if you just laid down... Like, if you just laid down and looked up, nobody would see your ass. They'd be like, where the fuck John go? Motherfucker's in the cave. He's a stalactite. Or stalagmite. One of them stalags. Ronnie.
Yo, I'm a 6-year Navy veteran, and I think that meme was hilarious.
It was hilarious until they fucking took me down. And it's the worst, cause every time you get fucking flagged, you just feel in your stomach, cuz it won't let you do shit. It freezes your whole fucking account, and you're like, what the fuck is going on? Then
that's some bullshit.
And then then it tells you, like, we flagged you for this because it was bullying or some shit. It's usually bullying. That's the cover all. Like, I was, yeah, me, I'm bullying guys that could kill me. Yeah, that's exactly it.
Nah, all the veterans got you, man. I've been listening to you for years, and I love the show.
Appreciate you.
Nah, thank you.
You know why veterans like me? Because there's no excuses. Go get that shit. No one's like, fucking look out for one another, and fucking ain't nobody gonna save you. You gotta save your fucking self, and that's why veterans fuck with me.
Exactly, exactly.
Go get that shit, son. Go get that
you,
shit. Appreciate you, man. And thank.
I appreciate you.
Thanks for your service. Let's go to.
Thank you.
Let's go to motherfucking. Actually, let's. Oh shit! I miss you.
I'm talking to you, baby.
Hear me when I say
I miss you.
Missing you.
Jamal, what up, though?
Hey, dude,
what up,
I'm
man?
I'm a Marine vet.
Yeah.
I fucking love all of the shit that you post. So fuck whoever is fucking with you.
It's some. I know some fucking fuck boy or bitch with a goddamn fucking coexist bumper sticker. Fucking
hell yeah, tell them they can't eat a fucking fat one from the Marines.
And the funny thing is they don't let me coexist. I want to coexist with them, but they don't. It's like that. It's like you can only coexist as long as you agree with them cats. And if you don't agree with them, they don't even check you. They won't even check you in person. They go and tell on you like a bitch. Like, look
Trust
at you.
Me, I know. I
yeah.
Yeah.
This is what you fought for, so that people can fucking tell on each other on fucking Instagram.
Yeah, and they fucking tell on us for doing our job and then having something to say about it.
Ain't that crazy? Man, I'm telling you, bro.
Yeah, bro.
All right, man. Shout out to you. Thank you, Jamal. Thank you, sir. Appreciate you. That's the shit that is. Sometimes I just want to leave this world, man. I'm just like, take me away. I feel bad for vampires. You know what I mean? Like, if I was a vampire, I'd just walk out in the sun one day. Like, fuck this shit. If I gotta listen to Justin Bieber to bite a bitch's neck, like, I'm not doing it. I'll just die. Fuck it. Take me away. Fuck that, I'm ODing this week. It's done. No, I'll make it to y'all fucking fight. You can catch me in Austin. Hey, sign up for go to onemorejude.com. Sign up for my email, because I don't know how long I'm going to be on Instagram. And also, I will tell you where you can watch the fight for free. Stream that shit. Chris versus John. Coming up next, we have Hung Young to talk about Hung Young Terrorist is her fucking, and she was in a cult. The Buddha Field cult. There's a documentary on it called Holy Hell on Netflix right now. And we're going to talk to her about it. 888-742-3345. I guess you don't really need to call yet. Thanks to all the Army people that got my back. I appreciate y'all. If the best way to do it is screenshot it and repost that shit. They can't stop everybody. All right. I'm out. I guess they can. But still, they can't stop everybody. All right, y'all. Coming up next, we're going to talk to a fucking person in a cult. Let's get it gone. Hung Young Terrorist. And you can follow her at I Am Hung Young with U's. Let's go. HUNGYUNG. Let's get it.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Cut back, aim, and I spray you like.
Shade 45. We got Hung Young Terrorist. You can follow her at I Am Hung Young, HUNGYUNG. And your YouTube is Hung Young Terrorist, TERRARIST. You were in a cult.
Yeah.
How does one join a cult?
Well, my big sister was in it, and she was like my half sister, so she was like 14 years older than me.
Okay.
So she was in it. Her best friend brought her into it, and they were like in their 20s, and I was like 6 at this time. And that was like the height when it was like super magical and everybody was young and beautiful and shit.
Wait, they brought you into the cult at 6?
Well, I was being groomed for it at 6. Like at
what does that mean?
Well,
what does groom mean?
Well, you know,
like, break it down.
Like, I was going after school to like the healthy, you know, grocery store and getting like, you know, the wheat free, sugar free donuts.
Yeah.
You know, just I don't know, just hanging with my sister who was, you know, super brainwashed. Right. And then, you know, by the time I was 10, I was like in the living room with my big sister meditating to Enya. So, I mean, that doesn't sound bad.
Which end, like Sail Away? Please bring up Sail Away. I want to recapture this moment. Hold on a second. You're keep going. I'll bring up Enya Sail Away while you fucking keep telling me this story.
I was also super sexual, but I didn't know that. I think it maybe it was like there was a Fellini streak in me, but like,
what's Fellini streak? What does that mean? Like the director Fellini?
Well, like my big sister was a stripper, so like she lived with my parents, you know, in this house. And I remember at some point I got hold of a video camera and I was videoing her, and I remember like zooming in and out on her nipple. I feel like this was at the same time, and she was probably, you know, she was like young and hot. And I remember my mom saw this video. And it was weird.
So you were meditating on this with your sister?
And it was all of this kind of converged at the same time. Like, my mom found this video, and I tried to tell my mom, like, because we weren't supposed to tell anybody. Like, that was, but part of the grooming was, like,
it
discreet.
Was a secret.
Yeah, you're not supposed to tell your parents, especially because, like, my mom's an attorney, like a PI attorney nonetheless. So, like.
Really? Way to finesse them. Like,
they for sure did not want her to know, because, like, that is so much trouble. And already, like, they were dealing with LA cult awareness.
Okay.
And all this type of shit. So.
So how old were you when you were actually brought? You said you were sexual as a child.
Yeah, I mean that's a whole different type of thing. I mean, I worked on this in therapy, and where it seems to stem back to is like,
were you molested or something? Or were you just like?
No, wish I was molested. I actually tried to get my my uncle to molest me. I think it was my cousin actually. I was like, let's play a game. Like, you lay down, you know, like Leonardo da Vinci star shape.
Yeah.
And I laid on top of him, and he didn't fucking touch me. Like, what the fuck?
You must have felt rejected. That's how John felt. John was raised around priests, and nobody would butt fuck him. And he's
really going for that.
Exactly. Yeah. Like, what the fuck was wrong with my asshole? I had an asshole just like all these guys, but like. It's annoying, but
it's funny when you see little fast children. I always talk about this. You'll see like I'll see like a fucking 4-year-old girl rubbing like fucking a pillow, and I'm like, oh, she's gonna be a problem. That was you.
I used a sock, and that's how, you know, if you use
wait
those,
how do you,
if
you how do you use a sock break well, that down
it you know it really I think is part of why I had such a great ass as a kid, because you have to grind on a sock, like kind of rub up and down slowly. Like I can't use my hand. It's sad. Like I don't know how to use my hand to masturbate. But okay, back
to
your
question. Well, you got long ass fingernails too.
Well, these are just recent. You know, okay. These are like my rapper nails, but these are great for rimming.
What the fuck is rimming?
I mean, like, you know, like ass play.
Oh.
I'm kidding.
Oh, well, be for real, because I was dead ass. I was like, you can rim with that shit. That shit. Like
this would be like this would scoop way too much like fecal
poop.
Matter.
All right, let's go. All right, so you said you was mad thick as a child.
I had a black ass like for sure, and I did ballet. But back to your question, like yeah, I did fuck kids like on the block and across the street when I was like 5, girls and boys.
Penetration?
Yeah, as much as you could. As
right.
If, like, is it in type
damn.
Of thing. But like I did give my first blowjob to my cousin when I was 7 and he was 11.
You did get molested.
I mean, but I wanted it. I remember like silently chanting like, please ask me, like, please, because my grandpa lived with us and like.
Did you molest him then? Do you think that?
I mean, I so wanted to do it. Like I was at my aunt's house and she was like old school Christian, like spanky with this wooden spoon type thing.
Did you get turned on by that?
I mean, it was like, he was so hot, though. I mean, this guy.
Do you see him still? Or
no, he won't talk to me. It's so upsetting. Because, like, the last time he was like, you know, would you ever do that with me again? And I was like, I don't know. And that was the last thing I heard. He's like, he's super guilty about it.
He feels really,
I mean, he fucked my best friend, too, which I was like, God, I told you about that. Like, she has no respect for, like, my, like, you know, family, like, sex things, but whatever. It's so upsetting. We don't talk.
You
to
felt
him
like
anymore.
You felt like you laid claim to him by blowing him as a 5-year-old.
Yeah, it's like, let me have my cousin. Like, don't fucking come around.
Yo. I'm just listening, man. Keep going. I'm just this is the judgment free zone, so go ahead.
Yeah.
Keep going. I'm listening.
I think he was abused as a kid, but no, I think I'm just purely sick or some shit, but I don't know.
Keep going. So okay. All right, so
we have a sip of this.
Drink whatever the
concoction.
Fuck you're drinking. What's in that Coke can?
It's just
whatever
Jameson
it is. Keep drinking
Coke.
It. whatever it is, keep drinking it.
Do you ever? Can you put ketamine's like a just? It's a powder. You can't put it in.
Nah. And I had to kick ketamine.
I left that shit in Hackney. I didn't get a chance to say it when I met you last.
Yeah.
But I didn't like that shit. I felt like so dead.
Dumb. Well, no, it's ketamine's good for buyer. Ketamine is good for by yourself and leaving the world for a little bit. Mm. It's kind of my deal. All right, so you were a sexual child,
so,
to say the least.
Yeah, I really
was. You did
was.
Get molested. Or
I don't think so. I think
you were into
I think
it.
I molested him.
You guys were both into it.
We were into it, but he just can't be, like, he can't deal with it at this age. It's kind of lame, but yeah. He won't talk to me anymore.
Maybe you gave a shitty blowjob.
That's probably what it was. That's probably what it was. But nowadays, it's really good. It's really. I feel like it's.
Your blowjob game's gotten better. I hope so. You've been doing it since 5.
I mean, I've been doing it a long fucking time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's fast forward past all of the child molestation. And how old were you when you joined? When you started getting deeper into the cult, and what was the cult centered around?
Okay, so I started getting singing lessons from this chick called Illuminata, who you might see if you see the film, when I was like 10.
Okay.
And I got initiated over the phone when I was like 14.
How do you get initiated over the phone? What do they do to you?
So you know that gorgeous girl with the black hair in the film that's like running her finger on the water on the pool? She like a dancer, Sophia. She sort of called me and was like, you know, because I used to go, I was instructed, I was like, you know, told to go to the Yogananda, Paramahansa Yogananda's Self-Realization Fellowship Center in the Palisades.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that shit. It's like, so that's like, that's like a cult grooming place?
Or
did they just kind of use that as... It's a kind of, jump off.
I think that's a jump off. And okay. Then he like kind of told me, okay, well, you know, master told me to tell you that Yogananda isn't your master, you know, that you, and that was pretty much like that was like all that needed to be said. Basically, like, he's your master.
Did you like the idea of having a master?
I still like the idea of having a master.
That's awesome.
I mean, it's not that great. Like when like my Indian client like wants me to call him master, but like the money is good. I do have experience with that.
So you do dom work, or what kind of work do you do?
Just straight hooker work, plain hooker soup.
But some of the people like to be called master.
Well, this one client of mine does.
Is it hard to call a master? Because it's like, because I've tried to get into like S&M and have like a chick whoop my ass, but like if they're dumber than me, I just feel like,
Yeah,
I don't feel right having them like beat me, because I'm like, you're a fucking idiot. I should be beating you. Is that how you feel with this guy?
I don't know how to do the dom work. I think I'm better as a sub. With this guy, I just feel like, give me my 500, you know?
Right.
My 400 turned to 500 when he saw my one woman show online.
Hey.
So, you know, but yeah, I don't know why, but you just reminded me of like, there's a part of your book where like some chick's jacking you off. And you like were upset that she was moaning while she was jacking you off, and I was like, made a mental note, like, if I ever jack off Jude, like, don't moan while I'm doing it, because it'll make him feel like it's fake.
Yeah, unless you're really into jacking me off.
But yeah, but like, see, but like, you know, like when you see like a little bit of like wetness come at the end, it's like kind of hot, you know what I mean? Because I was like, I was doing this. Well, I wasn't really jacking.
No,
well,
like, there's been time I eat pussy and that shit fucking turns me on. My dick be hard as hell eating pussy, and I've had chicks blow me and they get wet from it. So I can imagine someone, or I've been turned down by fingering a chick.
Yeah.
But this Asian woman was like, oh, so big. Oh, ooh. Like, I'm like, come on,
she
man.
She call you a juicy boy?
No, she called me, oh, you big boy. She's, oh, you're so big. I'm like, come on, man.
Yeah.
All right, so let's go back to you and the master. All okay. right, so you go into the cult. Does he have sex with all of the women in the cult?
No, he's gay. As you can tell by the movie, like, wow, he's super gay. But I had terrible gaydar and nobody was talking. You know, I got bored of the cult and I left an hour before. I mean, a year before it broke up.
All right, but you were in it for how long?
I was in it for like 8 years.
So what did you do in the cult? What does one do in a cult?
I did everything.
What does that mean?
I would go to the garden in the mornings and like feed the fucking, you know, the parakeets corn and lettuce and tomatoes and fucking, you know, walk with the master and all the disciples into the cage with the ducks. And like, you know, there's peacocks running around. You had to like be afraid of because like they jumped on somebody and like there were kangaroos. There was one kangaroo. I was like, oh fuck.
So what, you're at a zoo, that's it?
I mean, well,
and then you meditate?
There were so many things. Honestly, it was a lifestyle and I do miss it. There was like cleansings where like you pay $50 and you go in and have like a therapy session with him where he like has you close your eyes and he secretly watches porn while you like tell him your problems.
What?
And then like,
what kind of porn? Gay porn?
I think it for sure was porn because like you'd always hear like videotapes going in and out. This was like the 90s, you know.
Right.
Hear like, you know, VHS tapes going in.
So what
like,
would be some of your problems that you would tell them that you're comfortable saying, which is probably everything?
Well, I honestly don't remember. I mean, I didn't
so
have...
So you just lay there with your eyes closed and you're like, by the way, and then this happened and then that.
Well, actually, it was all related to my mom.
My cousin won't call me back.
Yeah, exactly. No, it was all kind of related to my mom, and it would be like, tell your mom, fuck you. You're 5 years old. Tell your mom, fuck you. And I'm like, fuck you, fuck you. And then I'd cry and then I'd like go home in like a super euphoric state. Yeah, I mean, there were just so many things. There was cleansing, so like there was that, and you know, you'd sit in a room and wait with disciples. You'd probably see like five to eight people a day, you know, for like a 2 hour period. Some people would take 30 minutes, and these were probably people that like knew his secrets, such as like, you know, his wife that was married to him. We would go on retreats, which were so fun. Like, you know, we'd get together as a group of 150 people and like go to like some fucking lake and like sit there and like he'd throw cherries and, you know, he'd throw like fruit and prasad, what we called it, and like share. Or like we'd have ballet classes and I would teach sometimes.
So this was like a community.
Super community. Yeah, I was.
Did y'all
was
do
incredible.
Anything weird?
I mean,
like, was there like no. weird sex or anything like that or not? Nah?
Not with us, but he was having sex. We just didn't know it. Like, we were told, don't have sex, don't have relationships.
You were blowing dudes at five on purpose. How did you not fucking have sex for 8 years?
Well, you know, I got shamed quite a bit. You know, I got shamed for being with a girl as a child. And, I didn't really lose my virginity until I was 19, right? Like, I feel like you have to go through puberty before you can say you lost your fucking virginity. But I had been shamed, you know, to the point where, like, I was like, in high school, I would just wear sweats. Like, I wasn't interested in guys at all. I would do homework on my lunch break. I got good grades, you know, and shit. I don't know why I did, because I didn't use it. But, like, yeah, I don't know. I lost my virginity to this guy who... I will describe as a garden gnome. He was definitely not physically at all somebody I was attracted to. And in fact, I had to, quote unquote, drop my mind in order to be with him.
Why did you fuck him then?
Well, I fucked him because I liked that he was like the second in command.
Oh, he's in the cult.
Yeah, he was like high on the hierarchy, you know?
Okay, so and you were attracted to the power.
I was attracted to the power. I was attracted to like his articulate nature. And he was really, like, he was just really beautiful. Like, the way he would describe things. He would like read like spiritual books all day and then like have amazing fucking sharings. And I just like, I don't know. It was like, you know.
How's the dick?
Oh, not great. It was not great at all.
Good talking, bad at fucking. In case you're just tuning in, you're like, what the fuck is this? I'm talking to Hung Young Terrarist. You can follow her at I am HUNGYUNG. She was in the Buddha Field cult, which is a Netflix documentary right now. It's called Holy Hell. You call up 888-742-3345, 888-742-3345 if you have any questions about this. All right, let's keep going. You were teaching ballet, getting having sex on the Did you have to keep the sex as a secret with the garden gnome from the main dude? What's his name?
No.
What's the main guy's name?
Well, he had a few different names. His real name was Jaime, but
okay, Jaime.
We'd call him Andreas. Cindy, we called him Cindy after 9/11 because we were all freaked the fuck out.
Why'd y'all call him Cindy?
Because we thought our phones were tapped, and so we had to give like some dumb name like Cindy says.
Your phone probably was tapped, to be real with you. That's when they started tapping phones. Tough.
But yeah, actually, whatever.
Jaime, what is he, Spanish?
Jaime Gomez. Yeah, he was like a little Venezuelan boy. He was actually, if you watch the documentary, you see he did some porn, and he was also that dude, that extra in Rosemary's Baby. Very memorable.
So I can look up Jaime. How can I find Jaime's porn?
Or is you got to watch Holy Hell. There's a scene. But actually, I'm doing a music video with the director, Will Allen, for one of my songs.
Of the porn? Holy Hell.
Yeah, the director of Holy Hell, Will Allen. We're doing a music video for my song Anal Big.
What's Anal Big?
It's like it's kind of modeled after D Antwoord, but like the first line, it's like, oh fuck me, anus liquor don't stop my camel toe lightning rocking this spot.
All right, dude. All right. Okay.
It's like gonna be a Japanese homage or whatever.
Are you part Japanese?
Part Asian. We think it's definitely Korean or Chinese, not Japanese.
But you're doing it as a homage.
Yeah,
to
yeah.
Japanese people.
Yeah.
All right.
Into it.
888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Let's go to Billy in DC. Billy.
Hey, how you doing? I was wondering if there was any sort of kind of ritualistic drug use, and as a result, you maybe had some sort of kind of blackouts and some sort of trauma related phenomena where you forgot what happened for a long period of time.
Not with me. I know some people smoked weed, which, you know, we weren't supposed to do any drugs. So, like, I didn't even try weed until I was, like, 25. I was really late. I didn't even smoke a cigarette until I was 25 or drink anything. No, he was just really hypnotic. Like, I think he'd taken classes in this shit. So, like, but to be honest with you...
What were some of the techniques that he used to hypnotize people?
So, like, at the beginning of our cleansings, he would be like, okay, you know, close your eyes, you're walking down the steps, and you would talk slow and hypnotic, like 10, 9, and then, you know, you get down to 1, you're like, you're 5 years old, where are you? He'd be like, where are you? You know, just with his like Venezuelan accent. I do miss it. You know what, being brainwashed is great. I swear to God, it's like takes a lot of responsibility off your shoulders of like trying to figure out this whole IRL shit
in real life.
Yeah.
So you actually liked, there's an upside to being brainwashed.
Yeah, I mean, like, he's still in Hawaii now with, like, 150 disciples, so sometimes...
Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah, so sometimes when I feel like giving up on life, I'm like, should I go there?
But will he let you back?
I don't know. I haven't talked to him for so long.
It said here that he preyed on young men?
Yeah.
And he raped them?
Well... I don't think it's rape.
He finessed him? Is that closer to, like, he talked him into giving up that?
Yeah, I don't think
he,
like,
was he a pitcher or a catcher?
He was hot. If you saw the documentary, like, he was a hot piece.
I don't care if it's Jared Leto. I'm not butt-fucking the guy.
Yeah, well, he was a top, I think.
Definitely not doing that.
But, yeah, I don't think you can call it rape because he didn't like hold a gun to their head, but he did like sort of, you know, brainwash them.
Okay. All right. So yeah, he finessed them. I don't think that's rape either. I think finessing is talking somebody into fucking. Like, I don't know. If that's the case, I've been raped a gang of times. I don't know how many.
Exactly.
Like, chicks have talked me into fucking them a bunch of times.
Exactly.
And I'm like, why did I just fuck that toad? But like.
Yeah. I mean, wow. I read your books and, like, sounds like you've had your super share of stanky pussy.
Yeah, fucking.
Like, goddamn.
Yeah.
I don't feel like you deserve any more of that in your life.
Nobody does. Nobody. The amount of fucking bad, whack pussy I've had and how many times I've been finessed out of fucking doing shit. Did he have anything that, like with Scientology, they have that shit where it's like, if someone's trying to get you out of the group, then they're against you and don't believe them. Did he have anything like that, where any safeguards to protect people from leaving?
Yeah, I mean, like, nobody was allowed to sort of, like, take a flight out or anything like that unless they asked for permission first. And a lot of times he'd be like, no. And then, you know, like, I don't know, like, there was one girl that was, like, the runner-up for that hot girl that, like, wore the sweater, that blonde girl in Dead Poets Society. And
she was in the cult, the Dead Poets
Society? The runner-up for that part. And then that girl ended up being stalked and killed, and he would, like, take credit for it and be like, you see, I told you you were meant to be, you know, with me. Otherwise, you would have been killed, you know.
So he used her death as, like, a fucking cautionary tale to keep people around?
Yeah, everything. Okay. And then if you, like, watch the documentary, you see, like, he actually had this one girl lie about, you know, him curing cancer to get everybody to... Yeah, I mean, he was... I mean,
were you bummed that he didn't bang you?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I was, like, we were all very hot for him. Like, we were all just... Yeah, I mean...
He's kind of like a pimp where he fucking does that and then withholds sex. That's what pimps do. They don't give you the dick.
100%.
John's like that. John's like a pimp.
It depends on the woman.
You get things from women and then don't give them dick. You're a pimp.
I mean, there have been situations where, yes, I...
He's
a
pimp. He'll jerk off next to the chick before he'll fuck him. Like, that's like...
Wow.
Yeah, pimp shit.
Yeah, I mean, I get spun on that shit.
Really?
A little bit. It's like, treat me like complete shit, and it's like, oh my God, I love you. But if you're, like, too nice to me, and it's like you're sending me texts all the time, it's like... Why do I talk to you?
Nicole in Baldwin Hills, California.
Hello.
Go ahead.
Hi, guys. I heard you all conversing about if you get talked into sex, is that rape? Technically, they call that coercion. Yes, it is a form of rape.
Oh, my God. I can't with this.
You can't, but no. I'm an MFT, and what's I have a MFT? Drug and alcohol counseling certificate. Marriage and family therapist.
Well, you make money off of telling people that they've been raped.
I mean,
no, I don't tell them. They tell me. And
then you'd be like, oh, yeah, if you get fucking talked, if I got talked out of fucking some dick, I didn't get raped. I just fucking got talked out of dick.
I'm going to tell you right now, legally, it is called coercion.
Hey, and let me ask you something. Have you ever seen a girl dancing like she's trying to get raped?
No, I've never seen a person dancing like they're trying to get raped.
It's fucking disturbing. You know what? I went to blow my rape whistle, but then somebody offered me a spot on Shade 45, so I blew him instead.
That's right.
Damn.
Well, because you chose to blow them, so no problem. That is not rape.
So you can decide after the fact that you've been raped.
Well, not necessarily. People are in the moment feeling like they're being coerced, and they feel like uncomfortable and like.
But that's just
how am I supposed to? How am I if I'm talking to a chick? How am I supposed to read her mind whether or not she's being coerced?
Well, usually you're not. A lot of times the woman is giving you signals.
But
a lot of times the woman is saying, you know what? I don't really want to do this right now. Oh, I'm not sure about this.
Yeah, but every human being.
The woman or whomever, let me continue, is pressuring the person.
Man.
The person says, well, no thanks. I'm not really into it. I want to kiss you, but I don't want to fuck you. But the person keeps on fucking with them, keeps on putting hands on them. Well, come on, let me keep on trying. Then the person says, well, no thanks. I'm not really into that. Could you stop?
Are they being physically held against their will? Can they get up and walk out?
The person is mentally wanting to have approval from that human being. So
that's
when you're having approval, especially in a relationship, it is called rape. And people do get arrested for it all the time.
You know, like,
This is a scary time we live in.
Times it's been happening for over 40 years.
It's scary.
Coercion is not a new thing on the book.
That's a really hard thing
to
prove.
That's crazy because, like, you know, even in a dating app, you have to have words. So, like, any words can be sort of used against you. Honestly, it sounds like you're helping people to feel like victims when they need to, like, man the fuck up.
Whoa.
Sorry.
All right.
Absolutely not.
All right,
what
Nicole.
I'm helping people do
What's
is
that?
Not be told man the fuck up because that's impolite to people and not supportive.
Helping them become victims.
Like,
you're
woman the fuck up then. I don't know.
Yeah. Boss the fuck up. Nicole, I'm going to agree to disagree with you.
Slut up.
Sorry. I guess I'm a rape victim. I didn't even realize that shit. According to Nicole, I'm a fucking rape victim.
Yeah.
God damn it. Y'all better be nice to me.
Damn.
Y'all better be nice to me. Let's talk to Megan. Megan, go ahead.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Well, I was doing good until that fucking crazy damn call.
Yeah, that last couple got a little intense. I was like, I don't know what I'm walking into, you know?
Man, go ahead. Just go ahead. But
basically,
no, it's,
you know, I
look,
just,
let me just say, it's important that we let every, that I try to let fucking dissenting points of view on the show so that they can get, so they can feel like they're being heard as well. I don't want this shit to be one-sided.
No,
I still don't agree with her.
If Dr. Laura Schlesinger wants to call in, fuck it, we're here.
And I don't care if it's, like, if, like, just because it's a law don't make it right.
So a little bit about me. I was, you know, heard you guys talking about cults, but I myself actually survived 5 years in a cult. I was tricked, though. I was a little bit of a wild teen. And my parents, instead of, you know, kind of wanting to deal with it, they told me I was going to go visit my grandma and my family and stuff. So I'm all ready to go. And then all of a sudden, basically, I walk in this door and a group of girls tackle me down to the ground, and they take my dad in another room, and basically I was left there.
Did you get wet?
So I got like left there. Like, it was a Christian military cult for troubled teens. So basically they come down and, you know, they carry you downstairs to this basement, and I'm only 15 years old.
Did they do weird shit to you?
Oh yeah, like first off the bat, like, you're just stripped down of your clothing. They make you wash down with, like, life shampoo, like, warm medicine. So, like, you can imagine, like, first of all, 15 years old, you're like, wait.
So it's
kind of
like, that's like the breaking down stage of you, right? Is that basically?
Exactly.
Okay,
yep.
So they break, it's like military.
Like,
they're breaking you down.
Rock bottom. Exactly.
Okay.
It's like the military, like, we want to break you so, like, you're a nobody, you're nothing. Like, you understand that you don't deserve to live. Like, you should be thankful for everything you have in your life. Like, you're a disgusting, worthless, you know, like, no good, like, tramp, you know, like, girls, like, you're horrible, you know what I mean?
So, and then what do they do? And then what do they do beyond that? All right, so, okay, so.
I mean, you're stuck there. So there's, like, you know, chain link fence, there's no phone calls, there's no interaction.
What did you do there?
You can't leave anywhere.
Was it just Bible study the whole fucking time?
Yeah, like, I mean, but they, like, work you, like, you're, like, you know, like a, you know, like almost like in a concentration camp, you know, like you're basically stuck, like doing, like cleaning nonstop, wearing like, you know, ridiculous clothes, like Bible study, like you said, memorizing the Bible. If you made a mistake, like corporal punishment was allowed.
Did you ever get, did
they
bring,
to do,
was it like a weird sex cult or just fucking them beating you and shit?
Just more like beating you and just
Damn.
Making you feel like you're just you know.
Your cult sound so, like, whack as hell. Like, you couldn't even fucking smash in it.
Too bad you couldn't switch cults. Mine was pretty dope.
You couldn't even like, you couldn't even notice the guys. If they even caught you like looking at the guys, they would punish you for it. And then they would use even the guys like against the
Lori,
girls.
Hold up. We're going to get you. Keep going.
Like, if they had like large girls, they would tell the boys to like moo at them, you know, if they walk by and stuff like that, just like, and make you feel like, oh, if you have biracial parents, like you're tainted. You know, if you've ever had sex with anybody out of your race or out of your sex, like you're tainted
Damn.
For life. Like there's nothing you can do. And you're just like, so
I'm
my
fucked.
Parents are biracial. Like, what am I supposed to do? Like, I have no.
You was just, you was walking around
like,
fucked.
Yeah, like you're just like, oh.
How you doing now? Megan, stop. How you doing now?
Thankfully, I'm all about positivity. I've just been working on just encouraging people and just helping them realize they can just overcome anything and just be awesome and amazing through it. I actually endured cancer while I was there, which was just horrible because
Jesus
I was punished.
Christ.
Is this real?
All right, man, I got to go. Yo, all right. Okay, I'm gonna let me talk to an attorney real quick. Lori in Queens, go ahead.
Hi, Jude. I am an attorney, and I have to completely disagree with the woman who has the MFT. You cannot be raped via talk or, you know, even persuasion, even if she goes so far as to say coercion. A woman has to make it evident that she's not consenting to sex, and then it is rape. But just to be like, ah, shit, all right, if you can't stop macking on me, I'll give in, that's buyer's remorse.
Okay. Thank you very much. So I'm not fucking some misogynist that's tripping. Okay, thank you. All right.
No,
cool.
Definitely not.
All right. Wait, I'm not a rape victim either then? So people...
If you said no and someone forced you, then you're a rape victim. If you said, all right, I don't know.
No, I got talked into it. No, I got finessed. I got finessed.
Yeah, sorry.
No, I know. I got finessed. I know. Fucking, yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, that's the way I look. I'm like, shit, man. After she left, I was like, damn, she fucking got me.
Yeah.
I just sat there.
You gotta respect the game.
Yeah, I was like, well played, fucking. She was fat and ugly. I was just like, fuck, well played.
Damn.
Just drinking out of
it. It sucks, right? But it's not rape.
The irony was, she talked me into doing rape sex on her. I didn't even want to do it. And like next thing I know, I'm like, I'm doing rape sex to her. Like,
you're doing the rape is fabulous.
She finessed me into doing rape sex. And I just wanted to just fucking...
Yeah.
I didn't want to do any sex with her. She was so ugly.
Yeah, this one coke dealer that I blow, he likes me to choke on his dick and like scream no while he face fucks me, and that gets him off, you know?
But that's all consensual.
That's all consensual, right?
Yeah.
There you go.
It's tough though. It's not easy. You know, sometimes I cry and then sometimes I'm like, why do I do this? But then I'm like, well, but it is hot, cuz like you're wondering, are you going to live?
How big is his dick?
It's great. It's definitely not like boyfriend dick. It's like, you know, a little bit bigger than boyfriend. Like
what is boyfriend dick?
Boyfriend dick is like incredibly average dick.
That's like, so you're not all cramped up and shit afterwards?
Yeah, like you like you won't get hurt by it. Like it might hit you mysteriously in the middle of the night, but like it won't hurt, like even like from the back.
And then... And his is one step bigger than boyfriend
dick. Like, it's like 8 inches, which I don't consider. I think like boyfriend dick's like 6 inches. Like 8 inches is like, I can't take more than 8.
BFD. Who the fuck? I just learned a new thing from you. All right. 888-742-3345. Lori, thanks for calling up. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345.
I'm sorry if I seem fucking broken, but you know, I don't know.
It's kind of crazy to talk to somebody that is this candid about their sexual experiences.
It's hard to take anything seriously, to be honest. It's hard to take anything really. I mean, I believe me, I have my moments, but then it's like, it's hard to like, it's like, you know, it's sort of like, I don't know. I'm in a place where I kind of feel like life is a prison. Not in a bad way, just like in a philosophical way, you know? It's just like, we're all fucking here, so like, you know.
Let's go back to the coke dealer. Do you like the idea of blowing him for coke? Like, you make money. You could buy the fucking coke. Do you like the idea of blowing him for coke?
I don't blow him for coke, actually. He just happens to be... He's like an ex-Ford model coke dealer. That he you know, that's where he took his career. But... I tend to go for gorgeous guys, like as palate cleansers, because I tend to fuck real nasty guys that are like my clients that I make money from. So,
how do you do? Like, how does that work with what's the proper etiquette for someone that's getting a prostitute?
I think I've been spoiled a little bit, which is hard to say because God, if you could see these guys, but like, I feel like, you know, I don't put up with a lot of shit. Like, I've learned my lessons. Like, I've learned, you know, I was trained by, you know, the best hooker mentor that you could ask for.
Well, what did she teach you as a hooker mentor?
Well, just, you know, like, how much to ask for, to get it up front, you know.
How much does one ask for?
Well, I used to not take less than 400, but now I don't take less than 5. And I know you think that's probably not a lot, but like, I mean, actually, Jude, I read your book. I know you pay like 150 max for like a hooker.
No. The last hooker I got, we dropped 500 on her. Me and my ex.
You know where to find me.
Yeah.
But I do charge double for couples because I feel like, I don't know. I might cut you a deal because I think you're cool, but like.
Appreciate it.
No,
I gotta get the last prostitute back because I did so much ecstasy I couldn't get my dick hard. So just on GP, I gotta fuck her properly. Like I just felt like, you feel like there's money on the table. So I gotta drop another 500 just to fuck her right.
Shit's so fucked up, Jude. Because like in New York, you know, I was actually with my John for like 5 of those days while I was out there, and he insisted on coming to see my fucking comedy, which is all about being a hooker.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, ever since he saw my shit, hasn't been able to get hard. I normally can just get him to like come in my mouth and shit, and like real easy, you know, like no cock ring, like he's 71. But you know, now it's like he needs to jack off into my mouth, and now I'm actually kind of worried about my livelihood because like this is my main squeeze, my main, like my main money bags.
Why would you, how much were you making off of him?
Oh, this year I made like 200 grand.
You made 200 racks off of this dude?
This year, yeah, it's been insane.
Why would you let him?
But honey, I worked for 4 years to get to this point. Like I was making, at one point I was making 1,000 a month off this guy, seeing him like once every other week. So like, you know, I've suffered. Like, yes, I do have a BMW convertible, but it, you know, most hookers get a new BMW after 2 months. This shit took me like 4 years. So I earned it. You know what I'm saying?
I'm not saying that hookers don't earn their money, but yeah. What I'm saying is, why would you fucking fuck with that? You're getting 200 racks a year. Like, I would just keep everything exactly the fucking same.
Well, yeah, I am. I do complain a bit, and I do. I am going to get him to get some.
Do you want some dick pills?
Life insurance.
Oh.
No.
Does
you know,
he take them?
It's just that, you know, I feel like I accomplish something when I get, like, when I get a geriatric to, you know, to come in my mouth without, like, you know, a cock ring and shit. So, like, now it's like my self-esteem's kind of, like, getting tested.
Do you think
right
he
now.
Thought you were unfunny so he can't come?
I think he's just so vain that he probably thinks that I really love him and think, you know, the second he starts tuning into this shit, we'll see what happens. But
does he know that you're on this?
No, he doesn't follow this shit.
Okay.
He's like a science guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, but I don't know.
Yeah, you scientifically made him impotent.
It was so fucking hard, dude. That night we did coke. Well, you didn't do coke, but like on the SDR show.
Yeah.
I had to go home and fucking have dinner with him after that, and I couldn't let him know that I had done coke. So I had like 2 bites of my sushi that night. I was like, I'm sorry, I'm just on a fucked up schedule. It was so hard not to tell him I did coke that night. I was like,
you can't tell him you did coke or else he'll judge you.
Yeah, I don't want to tell him I had to do coke to be on that show because, like, that you know, I got to fly out to New York in December, and, like, I just don't want him having any reason to feel like, is this legit? Like, he's, like, old-school Italian, you know what I mean? Like, he's not, like, hip, per se, although he does try to help me with my jokes, which is, God, you know, to be a hooker, writing hooker material, and then have one of your Johns help you with your material, I mean, there's nothing more depressing than that.
He's like, how about this?
Yeah. Like, you know that joke about you?
He's Italian. When he comes in your mouth, does it taste like Alfredo?
It's so bad. I spit.
Does he say Mamma Mia? Oh, Mamma Mia, that's a good nut.
It is like so hard to keep a straight face when he tries to talk dirty to me because he has like this super old school like Italian accent. He's like, oh, you have the best pussy I've ever had in the whole world. You are my girl. This dick is all for you. And I'm like, I don't want this fucking dick. Just shut the fuck up. But, you know.
How long does it take him to nut?
Lately, it's been taking longer and longer. God damn. We spend like a full on like 45 minutes doing shit, and it's just like, ugh.
Horny goat weed, yo, Hemby root. That'll help make his dick tingly. I'm telling you.
It tastes so bad, but I go and I spit right after, and then I like wash myself with like Lysol.
Fluffy likes big penises. Fluffy, go ahead.
Yeah, I just want to know, what is the fuck up? Who in the fuck got a boyfriend with a 6-inch dick? Like, that's average. Like, for a black woman, that shit ain't average. Like, if you ain't 9 inches, you ain't a fucking boyfriend. And get the fuck out of here with that little ass dick. I'm just saying.
Maybe you have a giant pussy.
You sound like you got a big ass.
Nah, I do got a big ass.
I wish I had that ass.
Yeah, right.
I wish I did. Yeah, I have a tiny little Korean pussy, so I can't really take more than 8 inches. It really does hurt for me. Like,
just because a girl's got a big ass doesn't mean some girls with the biggest ass can't take dick. Mm. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
it's an art.
And I fuck chicks that are super skinny that are like, God damn, she's got a big pussy. She got a big pussy.
You fucked a girl with a vagina as big as a condo?
I fucked the biggest pussy I ever fucked was on a 5'2" Chinese chick.
Damn.
Her pussy was so big. I just ended up fucking having to do, you know, when Kobe Bryant shoots a shot and does a little gooseneck. I just was doing the goose finger doggy style on her ass. I was like,
oh my God.
Yeah, just
insane. Fluffy,
you deserve big dick, by the way. You deserve happiness and you deserve big dick.
Yeah, I mean, I did take some black guys. I recently did give up on white guys, and I did go to the dark side, and Yeah, I mean, it takes like a day to get used to that. But like these black guys do fuck you all through the night. So like, you know, your pussy will stretch. You know what I mean? You know, after a few hours, you can sort of take it.
Is this civil?
Maybe so, I don't know.
Well, look, man.
I'm Chinese and black, and it ain't no problem on this end. So
there you
I don't
go.
Know to each his own, but you guys be blessed.
There it is. Yes, straight
love
up. Hey, look, too. Yeah, like that. Well, that's the thing is, there's different size pussies, just like there's different size dicks. So, if you're needing a 9-inch dick for fulfillment, maybe you have a bigger pussy. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, I'm good with 6. I like to be on top. That's kind of how I usually come, and I need them to fucking stay hard. That's like definitely for sure. Which I don't know.
All right, let's play a song. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. We got Hung Young Terrorist. You can follow her. I am Hung, HUNGYUNG. Is it up on the thing?
Yeah.
It's on the little thing. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. I am Hung Young. She was in a cult. She's now a prostitute. And you can watch her documentary. She's in Holy Hell, You're Blonde in it. Is that you?
Yeah, that's me. I just had toehead. So much plastic surgery since then, you won't be able to recognize me.
What'd you get done?
I'm just kidding.
Oh.
I'm half kidding. You'll never know. You have to take a good look and study me.
You got your lips done?
I can't. Oh, and the lips, I think I don't know.
That's the easy one to guess on a fucking chick. It's,
yeah.
Yeah.
But the lips is a thing you have to do all the time.
Yeah, you
gotta
keep doing
it. Over and over and over and over.
From a dude, let me tell you, it doesn't feel as good as regular
lips. My
lips
are soft, dude. I'm not testing you, but I'm just letting you know.
I don't know, man. Every time I fucked with a chick with them fake lips, it feels like I'm kissing a keloid.
Yeah. I don't know. I think I got lucky.
All right.
I don't know.
I'll let you suck me up. We'll find out. We'll find out. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345. Let's play a song, come back, and we're talking sex, cults, fucking PTSD, everything. Let's go. Shade 45, we got Hung Young Terrorist. She was in the Buddha Field cult, which is a documentary on Holy Hell. She also does stand up and she is a rapper. And you can follow her at TokyoCuntPunch.com. That's her website, TokyoCuntPunch.com. At I Am Hung Young on her socials. If you got any questions about
yeah, sorry about all the aliases, it's fucking confusing.
Whatever, man, we'll get through it. I appreciate you coming in and having such a fucking candid conversation about
my fucking pleasure,
your sexuality and everything you've been through. And it sounds like the cult has been some of the most lightweight shit you've been through.
Yeah, honestly, like I do have a joke about, like, you know, people are like, I'm like, well, how does one become a hooker? I used to meditate a lot. I was in a meditation group / cult. I had a guru. I spent the first half of my life meditating and surrendering to a sociopath. So I thought I'd spend the second half self-medicating and becoming a sociopath.
How's that working out for you?
Because life's all about balance. I think it's working out pretty good. I feel like I'm just like one consultant away from starting a great fucking cult. Myself.
So is that your goal, to start a cult?
Well, not really. No, I know you can make money that way.
It seems like a pain in the ass. I got to babysit people all fucking day.
So much work.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like I'm tired of giving blowjobs as it is, like already. So like, I don't know. It's a lot of work.
You could just lay back and have them eat your pussy.
Yeah, it's really hard for me to receive, to be honest. It's hard.
You're just a giver.
Well, you know, if they're really into it, I'm cool. But if they're like check in, I'm just like, dude, we're cool. Like, let me just ride that shit. No.
Just ride that dick.
Ride that day into the sunset. Yeah.
Let's go to Angela. She wants to talk about... go ahead, Angela.
Hey, Jude. How are you?
Fucking awesome.
That's amazing. So you guys just made a comment, about how all black guys have big dicks.
Or, no, that's not true.
Like, no, not all black guys.
It's not true at all.
No.
No, I learned
not
that the hard
true
way.
At all.
Shout out.
I have a hell of a story about that.
Well.
Yeah. Whoa.
You banged a black guy with a small penis.
Yeah, and you know what? Let me just tell you guys. Yeah. Let me give you advice to the small dick guys out there. You know, I was at a thing once, and this other black guy put my hand on his dick on the dance floor, and he didn't even have a big dick, and it was like, it was over. But, like, if you have a small dick, like, wait till we get naked, because, like, with the other guy that had a small dick, I did feel so bad that I fucked him anyway. And it's like, you have a better chance of getting fucked with a small dick if you don't, just keep it quiet.
Like, that's when, like, I get naked, it's too late. It's like, it's too late, you've already. Yeah.
How horrible of a person are you?
So, I'm eating you out with my t-shirt on, then I get naked, they're like, oh. Oh, bummer. I'm like, you're already wet.
But I heard you have a big dick, Jude.
Who told you that?
Ryan Keeley.
Ryan saw my dick?
She remember on the SDR show, she said you have a big dick? Because I asked you if you were Italian, and she was like, he's got a big Italian dick. My John actually has a huge Italian dick.
The guy that's like, Mama Mia, I love your pussy so much.
It's
like Mama's lasagna.
Dude, I asked him to clean his dick, never clean. Got that foreskin, never clean.
Ew.
Pull it back, you gotta spit on that shit many times.
Why don't you hit him with some baby wipes?
I do after, but because I think
do it ahead of time.
I think that's part of it.
He likes the idea of you sucking his dirty dick.
Oh, I think 100%. I think he's just completely, it's bad.
Well, 200 racks a year doing it, you know what I mean?
200 fucking geez. And then I walk around all day by myself just saying he's so disgusting. And then, like, people see me talking to myself being like, he's so disgusting. And I'm just like, but, you know, who likes their job except for, you know, maybe Jude? I don't know.
Even a job is a fucking job. Sometimes I'm sad and I got to come in here and fucking tap dance and make people laugh and shit. So jobs are jobs. Yeah. And shout out to all the fucking black dudes out there with small dicks, man. Sorry for you, man. It fucking sucks.
Yeah.
But do like Hung Young says, just fucking wait till it's too late. There ain't no backing. There's been times where I'm in some big ass pussy, you know what I mean? Like, and you just got to muscle your way through. Mm. They're not like, hey, by the way, I got a cave pussy, you know? Like,
yeah.
You just find out the hard way. Let's go to E and Flint. E, go ahead, bro.
What's good, man?
Man, you got it.
Man, this is like the best guest you ever had on here, man. She's so real. You know what I'm saying? Like, she just real. Like, the whole conversation, the whole vibe is just off the chain right now. I know you tripping because you like, bro, like, she must be turning you on or something.
I mean,
like,
I'm a little hot right now. Bro. I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, I can't.
Thank you.
You stay ready, though. You know what I'm saying? Like, you ready. Like, you ready. You know what I mean? For real. But big ups.
Yo, E, I got
to. You know what I'm saying?
A10, shout out to you first off.
Man, you are.
Pasadena,
know,
all that
you
shit.
Know
yeah.
Good.
Every now and again, there's a guest where I'm just like, whoa. You know what I mean? Like, where they they hit me with some shit where I'm just like, all right, let's fucking keep going. Usually I'm not shocked.
I know how you fly with this, man.
I feel like this guy's going to hit me up in my DMs,
man,
and try to get some free pussy. Like,
nah,
why is he trying to be all nice?
You straight. I wouldn't even do that. I'll come see your show, though. Like,
oh, yeah. Fuck yeah.
No, it ain't even that personal. Like, I don't know. Y'all ain't never met you. You know what I'm saying? But, like, I'm just feeling the realness. Like, you being real. Like, I just feel that. You know what I'm saying? Real, recognized, real.
Yeah.
Aww. Definitely come out. I'm doing the Honeypot show at the Mint on November 25th. It's a Monday night.
Are you gonna be in Michigan anytime or no? No.
I mean, why are you there?
He's in Michigan. Oh, that's why he's in Flint. Flint town.
Oh shit! I'm sorry about that water, dude. I have a sample about that in one of my songs. That water sucks a dick.
Hey, for real.
All right, shout out to you, man. Shout out to A10, and I appreciate and all of Flint, Michigan, the whole nine.
Come for me, will you?
Genesee County. Heads up. All right, bro. 888-742-3345. Craven in St. Louis.
Yeah, hello?
Go ahead, Craven.
Man, this lady here, she's open about everything. Has she ever thought about doing a porno?
Only with Jude.
I'm not doing porn.
No, I'm just kidding.
That's why she said only with me, because she knows I'm not fucking on camera. I can barely pee in front of people.
Well, you know, we're not allowed to. We're not filming this episode, but I am sitting here naked with my legs just completely spread and all my roast beef just hanging out. So,
You was doing so good, then you started lying on your pussy like that.
Just to give you a picture.
You can get naked if you want, but don't say you naked and you not. You won't be the first person to be naked in that
really?
Chair. Yeah, we get fucking buck.
I feel like I just got AIDS.
We get fucking buck in this bitch. John and I have had porn chicks look at our penises and the whole nine.
Wow.
We had to chill out.
So, I mean, are you into multiple, like, fucking multiple guys at one time, or?
I mean, how much money are you offering? Is this a record deal situation? Like, what are we talking about?
Damn, son. What's the wildest shit that you, what is the wildest shit you've done where you're just like,
me?
Yeah, like where you're like in the middle of it, like, whoa, like this is fucking, this is nuts.
Well, probably, I think the day that I had sex with five different guys, and I started the day thinking it would just be one, you know.
All right, so you had sex with five different dudes?
So, like, three of them were clients, but in between these nasty dudes, I had, like, you know, hot model dudes fuck me in between and remind me, like, that I'm a human being, basically.
So you would, like, fuck a nasty dude, then hit up a fucking model, have him beat the pussy up for a minute, and then
like
go
a child,
fuck.
Like, you know, 22-year-old fucking hottie.
Just all energy.
Well, and also, you know, yeah. See, the thing about me, what I think maybe perhaps the most interesting fact about me, I don't know. I think, Jude, you have this too, where, like, there's a fucking sick, like, twitch in your brain for some shit that's, like, definitely gross and fucked up and disgusting. Maybe I'm wrong.
No, you know, no. People have to tell me, women have to tell me what they're ashamed of for me to come. That's one of the few things where I can actually nut. And it doesn't always happen, but, like, that's my favorite thing is just, it's like a therapy. It's kind of like what the fucking, the gay dude was doing, except for, your cult leader was doing, have you say shit that you feel fucked up about?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but you just be riding my dick while it's happening.
Yeah, like, I feel like, yeah, I mean, this guy in Flint Ridge, especially, that I used to fuck before he moved to Vegas, you know, his wife would be out, his kids would be out. I don't know, he was, like, really heavy, and, I don't know, it was just, there's something completely disgusting about him. Like, I felt like I was fucking a hog, but there was something, like, so hot. Like, I would come with him every fucking time. And there was also this, like, super dick asshole that lived in, like, you know, Brentwood, who's, like, an attorney and just, like, such a fucking dick, but he was such an asshole that, like, I would just sit on him and I would fucking come. There's nothing better.
You like being degraded. There's a degradation to that. You're like, look how fucking disgusting I am fucking this fat piece of shit. And then you're like, bust.
Yeah, exactly. And, like, also that palate cleanser, Coke dealer, ex-Ford model dude that fucks me sometimes, he's so degrading to me. Like, he actually blocks me from contacting him all the time except for when he wants to come over and for me to swallow him. And that's when he, like... That, like, so, like, he doesn't get, like, none of my texts show delivered, right? Except for when he's, like, literally, like, the three words he always says is, want to swallow me, ? And then it's, like, yes, daddy, I'm ready. Or it's, like, if I don't answer correctly, then he, like, won't hit me up for, like, another month or two. And then it's, like, did you suffer enough? Like, are you ready to know, like, exactly what this shit is?
Damn, that guy sounds fucking cool.
Yeah, and I mean, like, this guy's, yeah, it's crazy. This is the guy that asked me to bite down on his dick, as I mentioned. He's trying to die. He's crazy, this guy.
Let's go to Blue and Phoenix. Go ahead, Blue.
What up, though? Listen, I'm just going back to what she was saying earlier. As far as a guy with the small penises, all black guys that believe that they have a big dick, more than 9 times out of 10, they have, like, the smallest penises ever. Like they think, no, seriously, they think that they're packing and they're weighing, especially the fat dudes.
Yeah, it was so, like, crazy. Because, yeah.
Like, they're slaying it. And you're like, what is that?
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Are you in there?
100%.
Are you moving around?
Yeah.
The worst.
I was.
degrading yourself is like fucking a guy who's fat and a small dick.
It was so crazy because what you're saying is so true. I was at Tenants and I met this dude. We were talking. Literally, we got on the dance floor. He put my hand on his dick, and you know what? The length was good, but the girth not so much. And it's like, where is this confidence coming from? And then, like, we got out of the club, and like, he wanted to kiss me. He wanted to like lock down some Netflix episodes with me. And it's like, we were kissing, and he was like, "You were so into me. What happened?" And I couldn't be like, "Yo, you know, you put my hand on your dick," and it's like,
was his penis hard too when he did it?
It was hard, but like, okay. we're talking like, you know, 3/4 of an inch girth. Like, I mean, like have at least an inch if you're gonna fucking put my hand. That last a quarter of an inch makes a huge difference, I think. You know. I don't know.
It's a game of inches. It's like football.
It's like,
dicks,
I mean,
are like football. They're a game of inches.
It's like, I'll tell a guy, like, I got a vagina as big as a condo because I want him to be surprised, pleasantly surprised when he finds out it's a tight little puss. But like, I 100%. I'm so with you. I love the guests that are calling in, you know?
No, we got the realest callers.
Damn.
Even the lady I disagreed with.
She's cool.
She's coming from a real place. We got the realest motherfucking callers.
Yeah, totally.
Simone, go ahead, Simone.
Yes, I want to know, how do you recover from all these different sizes? Like, how do you bounce back? What are your methods of tightening back up?
Honestly, I don't really have that much sex. Lately, I don't really fuck more than like once a week. So I think the pussy just does normally tighten up. That's just kind of what it does. Even like my older half sister, you know, she says the same thing. You know, I think no matter what your age is, your pussy will.
Did you ever fuck with your older half sister?
No, but I do think she's got a thing for me. She likes to watch me showering naked. And it's like, what is that about?
So you do. She watches you shower naked.
She won't admit it, but I think she does.
How do you know?
By the way, my little sister, I had a moment when she was born and she was real small, and I so wanted to molest her. You know, I so...
What the fuck?
But you know what? I didn't, and it's like, where's my fucking...
Good for you.
You know, where's my fucking award for that shit? You know, like, I just let her sleep.
You don't get an award for not molesting people. You get fucking penalized for molesting people. That's how it goes, Hung Young. You can't fucking molest fucking children, you
fucking
weirdo.
You know, and I told her, like,
how
I could have molested
now?
You, and I didn't. She's a little bit younger than me, like a few years younger than me. I don't tell people my age. So
So she's was she grateful that you, what,
not grateful what, enough.
When you said I could have molested you, but I didn't. Yeah. What did she say to that?
She was like, "You don't get a fucking award for that." I'm
it's
like,
true,
"Fuck you."
Don't. It's true. It's like, really, it's really true. You don't. It's.
I feel like I should get an award, like on the anniversary of every year that I didn't do that. A cake. Fucking Jamocha almond fudge ice cream cake with like, thank you for not molesting me and frosting on the top.
You're fucking ridiculous. G. Wiley, go ahead, man. You got a theory on vagina. Let's hear it.
Hey, what's up, y'all? So this is my theory real quick. I've been with a few Asian girls, and my theory is that the tighter the eyes, the tighter the pussy.
Well, that's I got big
my
eyes.
Experience. We'll see. Well, it's just a theory, just off of my experience, but I wanted to touch bases with you guys.
Her eyes aren't that big. You got like halfway Asian eyes.
Do
halfway
I?
Asian
well,
eyes. Yeah,
I'm
like
not
I can tell
Jameson,
that
though.
I can tell that you hopper by fucking your eyes. That's what
oh,
that's
really?
A giveaway.
I've been told I have the eyes of Krishna. By the way, my sister turned out great, okay? Where's my credit?
Where's she at?
My little sister?
Yeah.
I can't say.
I want to ruin her.
We don't talk. Well, she's marrying a broke guy.
That don't mean she's dead.
Well, she's dead to me because now she's eating into my fucking inheritance, so I'm upset about that shit.
Look at that. It sounds like you're doing fine. All right. I really appreciate you coming in and
so
fucking chopping up.
Thank you.
Tell everybody where they can find you, what your SoundCloud is, the whole nine.
You can find me on Instagram and Twitter at I am Hung Young, IAMHUNGYUNG. You can go to my website, hungyoungterrorist.com. That's hungyoungterrorist.com for links to videos, etc. And if you want to check out my comedy, you can go to tokyocuntpunch.com. That's cunt with a K because we are PC. And then I am at The Mint doing Honey Pot Live Show on November 25th, a Monday night at 11 p.m. And I'm going to be showcasing my full record, 30-minute set, and I'm getting a hot, hot pole dancer to choreograph the shit. So it's going to be hot as fuck. Come down.
Hung Young Terrorist, you can follow her at I Am Hung Young. Thank you for coming in and having, this is probably one of the wildest.
Thank you. This is the best time of my life, dude. Come on. Thank
if you were a dude, you'd get arrested right now.
I know. It's so true. That's actually what my friend said to me the other day.
You'd straight up, there'd be a fucking
but
cop car and people with bats waiting outside to beat the shit out of you.
I keep waiting for them, the policemen, to come for me when I'm on stage, but they don't. It's weird.
They don't take you. Yeah.
Can't get arrested.
All right. That was Hung Young. Don't go anywhere. More All Out Show to come.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that went longer than I thought it was going to go. That was Hung Young, y'all. You can follow the All Out Show at All Out Show. You can follow me at One More Jude, O-N-E-M-O-R-E-J-U-D-E. One More Jude, O-N-E-M-O-R-E-J-U-D-E. One More Jude on Instagram. And you can go to onemorejude.com and sign up for the email, where I'll fucking send you messages about, I don't know, like when the Chris and John are fighting, and I'll tell you where you can watch the fight for free. You can stream it. If there's anything going on, any changes in my life, I'll let you know about that. And it's just a good way to have direct connection with your boy Judy. Coming up next, we got the news with John. News from the chin. All right. Don't go anywhere.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
I know that you've not tried to have a child.
No. Past. No, I didn't.
But you still... won that race.
Every girl I got pregnant, I never was trying.
But let's say you were trying. When trying to conceive, a new sperm study suggests doctors have been giving bad advice. You should just keep on fucking.
That's what I said, and you were like, nah, it'll weaken the sperm. And I was just like, I don't know, dude. Like, I'm not a fucking brain surgeon here, but I just figure the more times you're busting a nut up in a chick, the higher the probability that you'll knock her up.
This is true.
That's what I would do. I would fuck every day and come in her. Even, like, I can't. It's hard for me to come from fucking, so I'd have to jerk off, like, edge, and then just shove it in her. And then we can have regular sex later. It's like you were made by me jerking off, edging, and just shoving it in, mommy.
Oh, boy.
Mommy. Mama.
That's a fun story.
Yeah.
What this new study says that in the past they thought that you were going to hurt the sperm if you were just constantly blowing loads.
Yeah, I mean, that look, if you're fucking like four times a day, by the fourth nut, like John can attest for this as he jerks off, as he has a chronic masturbation problem.
It's our problem. He's lifestyle.
It's so's your alcoholism, dude. It's a lifestyle. So is my fucking drug abuse. Like, it's a lifestyle. But you're busting like just.
Yep.
I've been there before, man. Like I've been like at the crib and I'm like, let me see how many times I jerk off. And by the end is just like fucking, it's like, please stop. Like it just comes out like fucking, either it'll be mad thick, like one thick dollop, or just like water. Like it's just, please come on, man. Like, would you quit?
It's pretty clear. Over yeah, here.
Mine is just like one little, and it oozes. Oh. It's like when you drink a good glass of wine, the legs, You know what I mean? You swirl it around and you watch the legs coming down off it. That's what my shit looks like coming off my dick. Just like two of them. It's like, sad. Sad nut. All right, what up, man?
Well, I mean, they're just saying that in addition to seeing sperm move faster, if produced after a shorter time of not, you know, busting the load, they found that differences made, well, at any rate, the sperm is stronger. The odds of actually producing a child are greater. So don't worry about abstaining from sex. Just keep on doing it.
Keep on fucking.
That's what you want to do.
Keep on trucking.
And I think I've asked you this recently, but do you see you trying to have a child in the near future?
Man, I was going to, and then me and my girl broke up, man.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, man, it fucking sucked. Real shitty. I'm kind of bummed. So, yeah.
Oh, no.
Oh, man, I find that was the first time I had a girlfriend in 10 years, and then we fucking broke up.
I knew better than to ask why, but...
just didn't work out, man. I don't even, you know, I don't want to fucking air all the dirty laundry on the thing, just out of respect for both of us.
No,
but,
of course.
Like, man, it just, yeah, it was tough. I thought I was really planning on, like, trying to actually have a fucking family, man, you know.
Really?
That's what I came out to Los Angeles for. I came out to LA to get some money. I was dead broke back in Michigan. I was trying to get some motherfucking money and go back there and like start something. And then I got this job, fucking got a drug addiction along the way, you know. Shit gets sidewinded. I don't know, sidetracked. And next thing you know, it's like 18 years later, and there you are, one bedroom apartment. What are you gonna do? Whatever. I ain't giving up. And the good thing was like it helped me fucking trust women again. Like it'd been 10 years since I had a fucking girlfriend. I had some major trust issues.
Here's where I always fall into a trap. I always try to remain their friend. Is that something that's in your future? You gonna try to?
I was like, look, we can't talk for, and I think this is what most people should do. Like, if you're trying to be civil with a person, I'm like, look, man, we can't talk for fucking 6 months.
Whoa. Okay.
You gotta let that shit blow over, let the feelings go away. You can't fucking rehash shit. And the other thing too is, if you really were deep with that person, you just can't fuck them like you used to. Because it's just too many feelings, man.
Oh, I know.
You can't take those feelings back. I remember, like, me and my ex would, my first ex would fuck and not get back together, and she would leave, and it would feel like we was breaking up again every fucking time she left.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man, it was just, it's like, dude, what are you fucking doing to yourself?
It's a waking nightmare.
And you got the good chemistry, so you're doing this shit, but, like, ugh. Guys, so, ladies, if you break up, stay broke up.
Yeah.
Like you can't keep going back and forth. It just kills you, dude. It just fucking kills you. And try to make it work. That's the other thing. Like try to make it work. But you gotta look at the red flags too. And if the red flags, if they keep happening and they're not, people aren't adjusting, then to me, maybe in your 20s or some shit, you can work with that a little bit. But like I'm too fucking old. Like, I'm dealing with older women, so their clock is ticking. Like, and if we're having problems, like, I don't got 3 years for us to work it out.
Uh-uh.
Have a fucking autistic kid or some shit like that, man.
Well, that sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. No, it fucking blows, dude. Let's just say my trip back to Detroit, nothing went the way it should have.
Yeah.
Fucking worst vacation I've had in a long time. But whatever, man. You know, you just gotta fucking, you take the good with the bad.
Yeah. Nas, it turns out, is tired of Illmatic nostalgia. He's just tired of talking about it.
Yo, real talk, Nas is like me with Hyena and Hummingbird. He's tired of talking about it. Quit repackaging the shit. He's sold Illmatic like 50 fucking times.
Still makes money, I'm sure.
Yeah, that's because that's his number one fucking, that was his classic, and it's a great fucking album. I'm not even a front, it's a fucking awesome album. But he's had the Illmatic fucking 10-year, 20-year, the tour, the fucking, the documentary.
I didn't know this, but he performed with a symphony. Did you see that?
He does, yeah.
You want to hear that for a second?
Yeah, sure.
It's not bad. It's not bad.
I'm sure it's fucking cool, man.
What up, kid? You know this rough after you slid. When the cops came, should have slid to my crib. In black, no time for looking back, it's done. Plus, congratulations, you know you got a son. I heard he looks like you. Why don't your lady write you? Told her she should visit. That's when she got hyper. Flip it. Talk about the ass too rough.
See, don't tell me I don't fucking love Illmatic. I'm just saying he's repackaging. And the crazy shit, that's a Q-Tip. That is actually a Q-Tip production, a Heath Brothers sample. And if you watch the movie Belly, they reenact that whole song where he's talking to a kid in the projects on the bench. Yeah. Boom. Wow. Fucking chock full of useless information. Jude Anthony Angelini, the Cliff Clavin of the goddamn radio world. Cliff Clavin's from Cheers, by the way, in case you didn't know. Arrah! Yeah, look, he's tired of it. Motherfucker, quit selling it.
That's what he's saying. It was 25 years ago. He's made other albums. I'm done. Thank you for appreciating the record, but it's over.
Okay, fine. Hey, check. Look, I hear you, man. Like, you keep repacking. You make something dope, you keep repackaging it. Calibri, the wine, Hummingbird. Hummingbird wine, available at onemorejude.com. Like, I've sold Hummingbird three different ways. Two different covers. I really like the Sunset Edition, if you can find that. It's fucking ill. And this hardcover paired with the goddamn wine. I'm just trying to get people to buy fucking books, man. And it's a good book. Everybody from the hood to the motherfucking, to the colleges fuck with that shit.
So he did just come out with a new album back in July, The Lost Tapes 2. So, but no one's talking. Well, I'm sure people are talking about it. But
he didn't come out with a new album. He just released old shit.
Oh.
The Lost Tapes. That. He's like, I'm tired of going back and fucking rehashing all this old Illmatic shit. Check out this other old shit that I did. I think, nah, for real, y'all. Peep game, I think y'all really gonna like this. This is everything that didn't make Illmatic, so enjoy. Bon appetito.
Well, do you think he'll hold to this, or 5 years from now?
Depends on how much taxes he owes and how much child support he owes. You know what I mean?
Well, he's doing something right. I mean, all this came out.
He had the Hennessy shit. Like, look, man, I fuck with Nas. I think he's a great fucking lyricist. But it's kind of disingenuous for him to be like, yo, I'm tired of fucking Illmatic. Bro, quit selling that shit. You the one selling it. I'm not dropping the 20-year anniversary of Illmatic. You are.
And guess who we told this to? I've never even heard of this. Hot Living. What the fuck is this? Some sort of like rich what, like lifestyle?
Oh, H-U-A-T.
Hot Living.
H-U-A-T-E. All right, there it is.
He's doing
he finds
well.
New inspiration. Yeah, good for him, man. Look, I fuck with Nas. One of my worst interviews ever. If I could take that one back, I would.
Oh,
I didn't know how to interview. Yeah, I didn't know how to interview. And I was like, what's up with your baby mama fucking everybody? That was the second question I asked him.
Oh, glad I wasn't there for that.
That was shit. That was like, I think, a month or two in. That's why, like, yo, dude, like, they really did Shade 45 wrong. Like, they needed to let us learn how to do radio properly before they kept bringing in these fucking big names. They brought us these giant fucking names that we could just blow, just shit the bed on. I blew interview after interview. Like, if I could take them back, I'd be like, bro, let us run for a year. Let us fucking tighten our shit up. And yeah, Nas, Ball and G. I didn't offend them. I just dick rolled them the whole time. And then what about that one song? That shit was great, right? No, fuck that. Let me keep telling you. No, don't answer the question. Ugh. All right, what else?
So, as you know,
this
homelessness,
transgender
kind of an athlete,
show me the tranny
she
lady.
Yeah. Is now winning these races.
This transgender
against, of course,
athlete,
women.
She,
it's a guy.
Well, it's a woman. I don't know what to
fucking do. I don't know what to say anymore.
Look, man, I will call you a she.
Well, it's a woman.
You can
I don't know what to
fucking
do. I don't know what to say
fuck
anymore.
Look, man, I will call you a she.
You'll never be as nice as I am. D-Block gangsta, I'll leave you right where you stand. What?
All right, y'all, we're having technical difficulties. Is this still happening?
Okay.
We gotta let us finish it out and hear some music.
Sorry about that, y'all.
Enjoy these tunes while we figure it out. Bye.
Yeah, I was born a misfit. Grew up 10 miles from the town of Ipswich.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
Shade 45. That was the show. Hung Young Terrorist came in and just fucking was wild as fuck. I am Hung Young, H-U-N-G-Y-U-N-G. On the boards, Chris. John is a producer sometimes, I guess you can call him that. Piece of shit, that's what I call him. Thank you, John. Keenan, associate producer on the phones and in charge of the fucking social media. He's the guy that you talk to at All Out Show. If you have any ideas for the show, any guests that you'd like to see, anything like that, hit up Keenan at All Out Show in his DMs. You can follow me at One More Jude on Instagram, at Rude_Jude on Twitter, which is that thing still on? And fucking onemorejude.com is the one thing I have control over that I cannot get kicked off of. So you should fucking sign up for the email there. Cause shit's getting hot for the kid. Shit's getting hot. All right. Don't go anywhere. It is the All Out Show. Let's go.